Kuruma, in the central islands of the Torres Strait, is known to Europeans as Coconut Island. The coconut trees provide water, food, and materials for weaving. But today, Lila is going to show me how to make coconut oil.
I mean, once upon a time, I used to be able to husk these buggers in about 3 seconds, but I think it's been a good 25 years now, so I'm heaps rusty and way out of practice. Oh. This is the first process in making the coconut oil. Yeah, look, yeah. What you see here is the actual start of the coconut tree. We eat this, and we call it musu. And it's a fibrous type of, like a fruit that's within the dry coconut. It's beautiful. All right, what we're moving on to now is phase two, where I'm going to scrape the coconut. This is what you call a coconut scraper. I used to be able to do this for my grandmother when I was a youngster. This brings back a hell of a lot of memories. 25 years, man. Dusting off the cobwebs here. Alrighty. So we're now into the third stage.
Once the soft flesh of the coconut has been scraped out, we soak it in water.
I could eat that right now.
And then get to work squeezing the milk from the shavings.
So this is stage four now.
The sabi, or coconut milk, will simmer away on a low heat over a couple of hours and reduce right down, leaving behind the fragrant, pure coconut oil.
So it's like nearly 4 hours if you boil the coconut milk, if you actually separate now the oil become up.
Oh, coconut oil, gar. It just brings back childhood memories. Mm. Everyone had the coconut oil going on, used as a moisturizer through your hair, so yeah, a lot of fond memories. Torres Strait Gold.